Trevor Alonzo, and I'm going to review Francis Ford Coppola's Captain EO. Yep, you heard that right. In 1986, Disney was looking to put in a new attraction. The idea was to keep it for a long time, so they decided to go with Michael Jackson. His popularity at the time was sky high. Michael wanted the aid of a high-profile director, so he picked the director of The Godfather, Francis Ford Coppola, to direct. George Lucas was added to write. So together, these three great minds came up with Captain EO, a 17-minute 3D film with stage effects during the screening. With a budget of $23.7 million, it was the most expensive movie per minute at the time. It opened up on September 12, 1986, with no end in sight. Until this.
Never, ever. I could never harm a child or anyone. It's not in my heart. It's not who I am.
Yeah, Disney decided to shut it down July 6, 1994 and replaced it with Honey, I Shrank the Audience. And it wasn't until after Michael Jackson's death that it was brought back for a few years. So, let's get into this. We first see The Rock. No, not that Rock. He's in Jungle Cruise. We see a spaceship rejected from Star Wars.
Don't get too close or you'll trip their intrusion alarm.
Yeah, don't blow it, you guys.
Relax, there's no problem.
Intrusion alarm!
The crew is made up of rejected Muppets and background characters from Star Wars. Michael Jackson shows up in what could be his everyday clothes to give orders to his ragtag team.
Rust fucking
order! Listen. The command considers us a bunch of losers. But we're gonna do it right this time because we're the best. If we don't, we'll be drummed out of the Corps.
Is this Space Corps? They end up coming up across an enemy ship.
Hold on, everybody!
Shake the set harder! Harder! Shake! I wonder if it was George Lucas or Michael Jackson that said, redo Star Wars, but cheaper.
Captain EO!
Incoming message from the big giant head!
Big size, the big giant head!
I'm sure this looked better in 4D, right? They end up crash landing.
I think we found the beacon! Captain EO! Take a look at this!
The homing beacon! We ran right into it!
Don't Yeah, we landed ass backwards into our mission. They get a message from their commander about delivering a map, which one of the Muppets already ate. They immediately get ambushed by generic space bad guys. We meet the Borg leader.
Silence.
I mean the Supreme Leader.
You infect my world with your presence. Turn the others into trash cans.
Turning them into trash cans? Why is she turning them into furniture? What is she, Leatherface?
And for him, 100 years of torture in my deepest dungeon.
Your Highness, my loyal companions and I accept these punishments.
He doesn't speak for all of us.
Captain, speak for yourself!
So we have come here uninvited and unannounced.
So, then we both admit to your stupidity! Why have you come?
To bring a gift, Your Highness. To someone as beautiful as you.
You? Think me beautiful?
Well, you're no Lisa Marie Presley. Sorry, that was my best Michael Jackson voice.
Let me see this gift!
Not only see, Your Highness, but hear.
The robots transform into instruments. Which one of these great minds thought of a droid farting a leg guitar?
Let him to my dungeon!
As everything falls apart, Mako turns the bad guys into flamboyant good guys. Yep, that's our mission. You droids turn into music instruments, you guys play, and I sing and dance. Let's do this for America. Space Corps! Wait, go to another planet to sing an 80s song? This is starting to sound like a Zap Brannigan mission.
Meanwhile, we shall sing top hits from the 80s.
Which 80s, sir?
For me, there are only one 80s. Smell like I sound, I'm lost and I'm found, and I'm hungry like the wolf.
Michael sings We Are Here to Change the World, which was rejected from his Bad album. Pull forward. Nailed it!
My lip wire!
Bad guys show up to whip Michael. They get foiled by a Furby. Michael turns the dollar store Cylons into good guys. So let's do the robot. With the power of music, Michael flies and shocks the leader. Turning her into Angelica Houston without Halloween makeup. Wait, we get a better song now? Cool, two songs. Wait, where are they going? So, part of a better song, another part of me? Not the whole song. Great. Well, that was Francis Ford Coppola's Captain EO, a theme park ride that I'm sure was more enjoyable in person. It's not horrible. It's no thriller either. It could only have come out in the 80s. Mainly because Michael Jackson's popularity changed after that. It's hard to believe Francis Ford Coppola directed this. Even though it was a theme park ride and had lots of products, at least it wasn't a comic book. Oh, wait, it was. Well, at least he didn't make any other franchises. Oh, yeah, he did. Well, at least that wasn't turned into a video game. Oh, it was. I'm going to give Captain EO a 5 out of 10 Michael Jacksons. Thank you for watching my video.